Hello, my name is Reverend Tom Stanley, and I am the senior minister here at Central Christian Church in Enid, Oklahoma. I want to welcome you to our online ministry. During these profoundly challenging times, it is important to remain safe, socially distanced, and wear a mask whenever possible. My hope and prayer for you and your family is that you will remain safe and healthy and blessed by God. Our online ministry here at Central Christian Church is growing. We are touching the lives of thousands of people every single month. Our goal is to share the gospel and good news of Jesus Christ, our love for our neighbors, and the welcome of God to everyone. If you're new to our ministry, please check out our website at centralenid.org and our Facebook page. A completely new website is in the works and will be rolling out in the next few weeks, so don't be surprised if it changes suddenly. If you would like to join this fellowship and partner your ministry with ours, we would welcome you with open arms. All are welcome in our ministry, fellowship, and worship. If you would like to support the ministry of this place as we change lives of people in Enid, in Oklahoma, and around the world, there are several ways that you can give. You can connect to our website and give online. You can download the Givelify app and find Central Christian Church of Enid and donate that way. We also have the ability to take ACH deposits, which are directly withdrawn from your bank account. You can use your credit card on the website or on the Givelify app. If you have questions about how to support the ministry of God here at Central, please don't hesitate to call our office. My deepest prayer is that God will bless you and make God's face to shine down upon you and grant you peace today. Have a blessed day.
It has been a blessing as well as a challenge. We have on the back of your bulletin are our announcements for the next couple of weeks. We have quite a bit going on as we close in on Easter. So I want you to be paying attention to what is going on the calendar. We have several upcoming events. We have an Easter egg hunt the Saturday before Christmas, or Saturday before Easter. We have the Lenten services on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday of Holy Week. Palm Sunday, we will have our Easter cantata. And the Friday before Palm Sunday, we have a 12-hour prayer vigil. Valerie will be getting that sign-up sheet out next week?
Yeah.
Next week? Okay. So, yes, ma'am. Yes. Okay, if you would like to pray from home, you are absolutely welcome to do that. We just want you to write your sign up on the list so that we know we have the slots filled so we can commit to spending that 12 hours in prayer as a church. It looks like this week is fairly tame. We have Valerie's Bible study at 1. We have Tai Chi on Tuesday and Thursday, the Emmaus Women on Tuesday, choir on Wednesday, and then Jim's Bible study group at his house at 5:30 on Thursday. And yes, I promise, brother, one of these days I will remember chairs. Golly. We have a host this week and next week at the Enid Welcome Table. I believe the 10th, we may have an open date. But here's some really good news. Easter Sunday, we have a host. We haven't had a host on a holiday in all of my time as the pastor of this church. So having one on Easter is huge. And I'm about 40% sure that the 10th is going to get taken because there's a Bible study group that meets at another church that wraps up their Bible study in April, and so they wanted to do it again in April, so they may take that date. So I'm excited about that. I think that if we move on into that next week, we've got Guild on Monday, we've got the Police Hero Project on Tuesday, Caregivers meet on Tuesday, CWF meets on Wednesday, and then on the 7th, we have the Senior Adult Luncheon. So just keep all of those dates in mind. Just keep looking at the calendar. The digital stream just crashed. Okay. So just keep those dates in mind and be looking for those calendar updates. We do have on Tuesday at 6 o'clock a special gifts committee meeting. That did not make it into the bulletin. And then on Thursday, for those of you on the Pastoral Relations Committee, we have a meeting at 4 p.m. on Thursday. If there are no other announcements, we will begin our worship service.
Praise Him, praise Him. Tell of His excellent greatness. Thank you, Marcia. Would you join me in the call to worship? The Lord continues to ask, "Whom shall I send?" Here we are, Lord, send us. The Lord's answer is, "Go and tell the story of God's love through Jesus the Christ." Would you join us in singing hymn number 5, "Othra, for 1,000 tongues to sing." Pray with me. Holy Lord, the God that hears our prayers, you have said that you will be present whenever two or three gather in your name. We welcome your presence and grace in our lives. We ask that you manifest your glory today and shine your light on us. Through your light, may we illuminate the lives of those around us. As we feel your presence in worship today, may our knowledge of your divine mysteries continue to grow and change our lives forever. Amen. You may be seated. Our scripture today is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 16 through 21. From now on, therefore, we will regard no one from a human point of view, even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view. We know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, There is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything new has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ. Since God is making his appeal through us, we entreat you on behalf of Christ to be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God.
Bless the Lord, my soul, come before your singing. Praise the Lord, you angels and mighty ones of God. Bless the Lord, my soul, come before him with dancing. Praise the Lord, you heavens and stars up in the sky. Forget not all his many blessings. Remember who redeems your soul, who fills your life with love and beauty, who wakes you up and makes you whole. Bless the Lord, my soul, come before him with singing. Praise the Lord, you angels and mighty ones on high. Bless the Lord, my soul, come before him with dancing. Praise the Lord, you heavens and stars up in the sky. Forget not all his many blessings. Remember who redeems your soul, who fills your life with love and beauty, fills you up and makes you whole. Bless the Lord, my soul, come before you with singing. Praise the Lord, you angels and mighty ones on high. Bless the Lord, my soul, come before him with dancing. Praise the Lord, you heavens and stars up in the sky. Praise the Lord, you heavens and stars up in the sky. Praise him, all creation, and lift your name on high.
I think Randy picks those on purpose to see how bad I struggle in the 8 o'clock service. That's the whole reason I knew it was. Oh, my goodness gracious. On the back of your bulletin is our concern list. We continue to pray for Joe, Lonnie, Sherry, Noel, Nancy, Barice, Virginia, Roger, Krista, Brandy. Shirley has asked to be taken off of that list. Scott, we're glad to see you, brother, and glad you're here, and so glad to celebrate your recovering. We continue to pray for Dan and Todd, Allie. The young lady, Allie, that I told you about last week is 16 years old, had emergency brain surgery last week. They were unable to remove the entire tumor. She has been sent to a more specialist. I don't know what that means. But they're hopeful that this new uber specialist will be able to get the rest of the tumor. In the meantime, she is approaching chemo and radiation at the same time in the hopes that they can continue to treat her while they're waiting on the second surgeon to evaluate her. We continue to pray for the Schaefer family, who is the family of the 5-year-old who was killed in the ATV accident. We continue to pray for Brittany, and the Ukrainian people. Are there others that you would bring before this body that we need to be praying for today? I did not. Thank you. Yep. I ran into Forrest Ridgway, well, Forrest, 2 weeks ago at lunchtime on Sunday afternoon, and he asked us to be praying for him as he has several big test results pending. And so I invite you to be praying for him and his family. The Tishomingo community. Yes, ma'am. They had 6 teenagers in a car accident, and I believe they were all killed. They were hit by a semi. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. I tell you what, we're going to do that differently. Before we go to prayer, if you would like to join me down here, if you are able, or as you are able, if you would like to offer a word of prayer, I will begin and close this time of prayer. But if you would like to offer a word, you are welcome. Holy God, all too quickly we get used to the news. All too quickly we get desensitized to the things and the people who are hurting in this world. So today, as we gather in your name, open the eyes of our hearts. Open our ears that we may hear the cries of your children. That we may see this world as you see it. Hurt for this world as you do.
Help our country as we deal with what's going on. Help our leaders. We desperately need them.
God of grace and mercy, hear the prayers of your children here today and around the world. Turn our hearts towards you that we may show this world it can be different because of your love, that this world can be a safe place for children, a place where they are fed and cared for, that this world can be a place where countries don't rob each other, that this world can be a place where your name is glorified. We lift up all of these on our prayer list to you, O God. We know you are already there. We celebrate that you are pouring your Spirit out in them already. But your Son taught us it is good to ask, and so we ask that you are present with them, that you pour out your Spirit of strength and grace and mercy in them, that you bring healing, comfort, and peace in all things, as we pray the prayer your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who sin against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. See, when I do it from memory, I slip back into those childhood moments.
Till their hearts be sad.
Amen. 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 Isaiah chapter 6 is perhaps one of my very favorite scriptures. It is the words of the prophet Isaiah and a vision given to him by God. It starts out, "In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne. High and lofty, the hems of his robe filled the temple. Seraphims were in attendance above him. Each had six wings. With two they covered their faces. With two they covered their feet. And with two they flew. And they cried out together in a loud voice, 'Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory.' The threshold shook at the sound of their voices, and the whole of the temple was filled with smoke. And I cried out, 'Woe is me! I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. And yet I have seen the King, the Lord of hosts.'" And then I heard the voice of the Lord cry out, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" And the prophet Isaiah answered, "Here I am, send me." And God answered, "Go and say to my people, keep listening, keep looking, make the mind of this people. Listen and see." All too often, we get desensitized to what is going on in the world. All too often, we stop listening, stop seeing. Or even if we do see and do listen or do hear, we don't actually see and actually listen to what is happening. It was Wednesday this week before it even dawned on me to check on the situation in the Ukraine. It's been a month. It's been 2 months. I get used to it. I saw the news of the crash in Tishomingo, and yes, I was sad for those families. But it's just one more crash. We, the people who are called by the name of Christ, must look and see and hear and listen differently. We have to pull off the blinders of every day. We have to pull off and throw away those old interpretations and those old ways of being. This week in the Easter devotionals, in the Lenten devotionals that are available still out on the Welcome Center, all of the narratives, all of the stories were about the people of God actually seeing and hearing what is going on in the world. And I began to read those and study and wonder what we needed to hear as God's people today. Over the last several weeks, I have been leading the pastor's class. We've talked about the Bible, about faith, about who Jesus is, about what it means to be a follower of Jesus. And these are amazingly deep topics for our children. And yet to hear them explain these topics has been such a blessing. Wonderful and life-giving as they share with me what they believe it means to be called by Christ's name. To hear their faith stories has been amazing. And I knew as I began to read and ponder all of this, I needed to blend these three stories together. We know what new faith looks like. We know what mature faith looks like. We know what middle of the road faith looks like. We've all been in all of those places. But sometimes we get a little too comfortable. Sometimes we just want to be. But that is not who we are called to be. We are called, challenged, given the opportunity to see the world through new eyes, to listen to the world through new ears, to feel this world through new hearts in Jesus. And that's exactly what Paul is telling the church at Corinth. In fact, Paul is telling them an impossibility. How can they become new? How could they be born again, a new creation? And yet that's exactly what we teach. By accepting and claiming Jesus as our Redeemer, the love of God comes to dwell in us, making us something new. I want you to hear these words from the Apostle Paul again. From now on, therefore, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even though we once regarded Christ according to the flesh, we regard him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, they are a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. All of this is from God, who through Christ reconciled us to himself and gave us the reconciliation ministry that is in Christ. For he is reconciling the world to him. Hear those words again. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, they are a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. We teach this. We instruct our children in this. And part of our journey through Lent needs to be a reminder to those of us who've gotten a little more comfortable. Because sometimes we forget, and it's easy to slip back into old habits. It's easy to look at the world through older eyes, eyes before we met Jesus, to listen to the stories people tell with those old ears rather than those new ears that Jesus gave us. It's easy to sit back and look at the world and go, well, that's happening way over there. I'm good right here. But that is not what Jesus teaches us. That is not who we are called to be in this world right now. We are something altogether new. We are something that has been given new eyes, new hearts, new ears to listen, see, and hurt for this world as Jesus does. And yes, I fully acknowledge how hard that can be. But that is who we are supposed to be. Justo Gonzalez is a modern theologian that I discovered in seminary. I know the Crusader class has had several several different lessons by him, and he is always an interesting read. He wrote these words, "In my daily life, we never simply use the word therefore. We never say, therefore I will not be there. There is always an antecedent, a reason why we will not be there." And yet when we read the Great Commission, we pay no attention to it saying, "Go you therefore." And the same thing happens in this 2 Corinthians text. If we read carefully, we know it begins with the word therefore. It gives us a hint to go back and look at what Paul is trying to draw us to. In fact, he says that there is a long sequence of words that Paul is drawing us to throughout the epistle. And all of them, nearly, are impossibilities. Things we could not do for ourselves. Gonzalez goes on to say that there were often times where Paul was accused of being crazy, because what he spoke of was impossible. Paul writes in 2 Corinthians 5:13, "If we are in our right mind, it is for God." That sounds as nonsense to the unbeliever. We are new creations. Again, nonsense to the unbeliever. And yet, for us here today, it is exactly who we are to be. We are to live into those new lives that the love of Christ has given us. We are not crazy when we realize that we are to be dead to our former selves, even as Paul writes to the Corinthians that they are indeed dead. Christ himself has changed us. And perhaps craziest yet, that we proclaim we are new. Jesus promises us a new spirit, a living well within us that is constantly renewing us, constantly filling us with God's Spirit. Can we help but be new? Paul isn't just saying that believers are new creations. Paul is challenging us and all believers down through history to see the world differently, to hear what is going on in the world differently than we did before, to see, hear, and hurt for the world just as Jesus does. Is it any wonder that those non-believers in Corinth thought Paul might be deranged? But this craziness is at the very heart of the gospel. It is at the very heart of what it means to be called by the name of Christ. It is at the very heart of what it means to be a believer in Jesus. In Christ, God is reconciling the world to himself. Everything old has passed away. See, the new has come. So I wonder why we get so comfortable. I wonder why we sit back and look at the world through those old eyes. I wonder why we forget to listen with that new heart Jesus gave us. Because if we are seeing this world, hearing this world, experiencing this world through the lens of the love and grace and mercy of God through Jesus, how can we possibly do that through our old selves? You see, those old selves don't see the world the way Jesus did. They don't hear and experience the world as Jesus did. They are blinded to the mercy and grace of God through Jesus. And if we are using those old eyes, those old hearts, those old ears, we are definitely doing it wrong. So my hope and my prayer for you this week, as we continue our journey towards Lent, is that God will open the eyes of your heart, the ears of your heart, that you will see and hear this world the way God does, that you will hurt for this world. The same hurt that brought Jesus down out of heaven and into this world to be born in a manger. The same urgent need that held Christ on that cross. That is who we're supposed to be today. Would you pray with me? God, we do indeed need you every hour. We need to be reminded over and over and over again that we are not only yours, but this world is yours. That our hearts belong to you, and that you have indeed changed us. That we must take on your spirit, take on your light, embody your love, your grace, and your mercy for this world today. And for when we fail, we ask your forgiveness. When we fail to live into that mercy and grace, we ask your forgiveness. When we fail to offer that grace and mercy to others, we ask for forgiveness. But more than that, we ask that you remind us of who we are, what we are to be, and how we are to experience this world. In the precious and holy name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. We'll sing hymn number 578, I Need Thee Every Hour.
Temptations of the bar when thou art high.
So someone escaped my eye while I was standing up here. Shirley, it is good to see you, ma'am. I am so glad you're here. I get asked a lot, how are things going at the church? You know, I grew up in that church. I was married in that church. We don't go there anymore. And I always have a story. I have the elevator speech. But this week, it pivoted a little bit. While Mickey and I were at Rotary on Monday, we received the second gift for the welcome table this week. The welcome table received $6,000 this week from two separate gifts. That's our story. As I'm standing there, of course, they handed me a microphone, and you know, hey, I'm a pastor, I'm going to talk if you're going to hand me a microphone. And I was sitting there thinking on the spot, and I looked at Mickey and I said, I think we've got more meals served than our board says. We're far closer to 30,000 meals than we are 20,000 meals. In the 5 years this church has hosted the welcome table, 30,000 nearly meals have been served out of this building. That is changing lives. That is hurting for this community the way Jesus does. Pat Owens posted a thought in the kitchen group, or the welcome table group, I don't remember which, that 18.6% of Oklahomans are food insecure. And that number is significantly higher when you just look at children. Mickey came back with that nearly 90% of the kids in the schools in Enid area are on free or reduced price lunches. I want you to think about what that means. Since our dollars for mission today is the welcome table, I couldn't think of a better time to share that story. As you give today, I hope that God has spoken to your heart, that God has shown you the new eyes and ears and heart that God has granted you again. That maybe, just maybe, the people of God need to remember anew what it means to be called by the name of Jesus. Let's take the offering. Would you stand as we sing the doxology together?
You pray with me. Lord, as we bring our offerings to you, we give back to you from the abundant blessings you have given us. May our gifts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord our God. Blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor and power and strength be unto you, our God, forever and ever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. As we come to this table today, we ask God to remind us again who we are. That we are God's people, that we are the sheep of God's field, the wheat of God's crop. And that we ask God to renew us, prepare us, and send us out not only for today, but every day, especially as we approach Easter together. As they were in that upper room that last day before the cross, Jesus took bread, he gave thanks, he blessed it, he broke it, and said, "This is my body, and it will be given for you." He took a cup after they had eaten, he gave thanks, he blessed it, and said, "This is the cup of the new covenant. As often as you eat this bread and you drink from this cup, remember me." There's no way we can fully encapsulate everything that we have experienced in Jesus in one moment. But today, let us dwell in the grace and mercy and the newness of life in Jesus the Christ.
Will you pray with me? Dear Lord, help me to seek you more and more for who you are and not just that which you provide. Lord, that I may spend time in your presence, not for what I can get from you, but for what I can give to you. Lord, that you would fill me with your love so that my love may flow back to you as well as out to others. Lord, I pray that my life may be a life that glorifies you in thought, word indeed, and that with each passing day, I draw ever closer into close communion with you. Hear us as we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
God, as we take the bread today, scrub our hearts clean. Remind us again that we are new. And as we take the cup and share it together, send us out. Send us out, Lord. If you would know this one who makes you new, this altar is open. I or one of our elders would love to share that story with you. If you need a moment of renewal, this altar is open. Again, we would love to pray with you. Or if you just wish to kneel in prayer, you are welcome. If you would partner your ministry with this place, we would welcome you with open arms. Let's stand and sing. Living for Jesus. The song said it all. Go and live for Jesus. Go and tell the story that you are new and that others can be as well. Go and live for Jesus. Amen.
And although we are Christians, but